Hey, Mustangs!
I'm Louie.
And I'm MK, here with your broadcast for the week of December 18th.
Hey, have you been down to the school store recently?
Yeah, I was just down there. These slushies are to die for.
Oh,
brain freeze!
Well, there's more than just slushies down there, so let's send it to Drew and Kenzie to see what else is going on in our school store.
Hey, Mustangs, it's Drew.
And Kenzie here with your school news segment for the week.
Kenzie, did you know we had a school store?
No, I didn't. When is it open?
It's open during A and B lunch in the Commons, and it has sweatshirts, t-shirts, pants, slushies, and more.
Let's check in with some school store employees to learn more about what it has to offer.
You should purchase some stuff from the school store because we got lots of new apparel. We have new sweatshirts and new crew necks in multiple different sizes and colors.
With Christmas coming up, these crew necks would be the perfect present to buy someone. It'll be easy to buy because you're already in school. And we also have a new slushy flavor, and it's really good. It's Arctic Berry, and it's really good.
This year we're trying to have the store open during basketball games so that students and parents can come in outside of school times and not just during A and B lunch.
If you'd like to purchase these awesome sweatshirts or other school apparel, visit the school store during your lunch.
You can also check out the store on Instagram and TikTok at PC School Store 2024.
That's it from us Mustangs. Back to MK and Louie in the studio.
Thanks, guys.
Hey, MK, look what I drew. Can you guess what it is?
No.
Santa on a rocket ship.
Ah, well, maybe our Mustangs will be better at deciphering than me.
Now over to Peyton and Labib with some holiday Pictionary.
Hey, Mustangs, it's Peyton.
And Labib.
Here with your comedy segment for the week.
Hey, Peyton, can you guess what this is?
Labib, it looks like a blob to me. I think our Mustangs will do a much better job at holiday Pictionary.
Santa.
Yep, yep.
Huh?
Pineapple. A house.
Nope.
A door. I have no clue.
See, I told you they'd be much better at it than you.
I'll do better next time. Trust.
Well, that's all for us this week.
Happy holidays, Mustang.
Now back to the studio.
Wow, great job, guys.
Hey, MK.
What the heck are you wearing?
Put these on. We're going to go over to the pool to practice some dives with the swim team.
I thought you'd never ask, but first, Adam with the athletic rundown.
Hey, Mustangs. Adam here with your sports rundown for the week. To start off the week on Tuesday, your boys and girls basketball team face Harper Creek. Going on to Wednesday, the wrestling team has a match at St. Joe, as well as the Muskies hockey team facing the Kalamazoo Eagles. On Thursday, boys and girls basketball take on St. Joe, and to wrap up the week on Friday, the Muskies play Lumen Christi Catholic High School. For more games, dates, information, go to pcmustangsports.com. Now sending it to Alex to take a deeper dive into your boys' swim and dive team.
Hey Mustangs, Allie
and Peyton
here with your athletic segment for the week.
Our boys varsity swim and dive team have started their season off strong.
Let's dive in and ask some of our swimmers about how the season is going so far.
Good so far. I've been having some mental blocks. There's this season there's two new swimmers.
So far it's been really good. I've knocked off a lot of time already, and a lot of the other guys have been doing great. They've, for all the guys that I know have been doing swim before, they've all improved their times drastically.
It's been pretty fun. The first meet was just relay, so we got a lot of team bonding in there.
It's been going great so far. We've had a big team, especially since last year. We had like 13. This year we have like some 20-something. So I think it's going great.
My goals are to compete on the same level as the guys who have been swimming for like way longer than me.
Favorite part, I just like swimming. Just the feeling the water, honestly. That's my favorite part.
Thanks, Mustangs.
Sounds like a great season ahead of us.
Back to MK and Louie in the studio. Good luck this year, guys.
Now just one.
No! I told you no.
My bad. Maybe kids in science could teach me a thing or two.
Let's hand it over to Drew and Reagan to learn more about it.
Hey, Mustangs. It's Drew and Reagan here, bringing you your activities for this week.
Kids in Science aims to expose elementary students to more science. They engage in fun experiments that seek a passion for science at a young age.
Let's hear from our co-presidents to hear more.
I decided to join Kids in Science because I've always been interested in science, and I think it's a good idea to spark this passion for STEM in younger generations.
I started my freshman year because both of my siblings started doing it, and they said that it would be a really fun opportunity to learn more in science and hang out with the kids.
My favorite part of the club is just like getting connections with the kids. We go there every other week, so after a while you get to know the kids, and it's just a really good activity.
My favorite part of the club is definitely seeing like all the kids get excited about whatever experiment we decide to do that week.
We meet every Friday. Half are in Miss Bannett's room and half are at Moores Bridge.
You can email either me or Nathan in order to get into our Google Classroom.
Sounds like a great club to be involved in.
Now back to the studio.
Wow, I wish I knew that before. NK!
I can't find the word risen here, and apparently it's Oxford's word of the year.
Wait, really? Wait, let me look at this. Oh, it's because you got the old one. You got to get the new version.
Oh, yeah, there it is. Yeah, no, I still don't get it. Can you explain it to me?
Maybe some of our Mustangs can help out with that. Take it away, Hamid and Malia.
What's up, Mustangs? It's Hamid.
And Malia.
Every year, the editorial staff at Oxford Languages come together to choose the word of the year, a word that reflects the ethos, mood, or preoccupations of that particular year and has lasting potential as a word of cultural significance.
There are many contenders this year, like parasocial, beige flags, swifty, and situationship, but RIS came out on top, defining it as someone's ability to attract another person through style, charm, or attractiveness. Now let's ask some of our Mustangs and staff what RIS means to them.
So this RIS thing, it means respect.
I think RIS means awesome.
Skills with talking to people would be RIS.
My definition of RIS is charisma. So it's the way you carry yourself. It's the way you talk. It's like eye contact.
I think RIS is like unspoken, like words, like if you want someone's attention or if you like them.
It's clear RIS has a variety of meanings, people. But I guess that just shows how RIS RIS'd us up this year and how much a lot of need to improve your RIS-ing.
Now back to the studio.
Thanks, guys. Now I understand.
Well, that's all from us this year.
I'm Louie.
And I'm MK.
Signing off.
No, no, no!